All right, good evening, everybody. Can I have your attention? If you can find a seat, please do. How's everybody doing this evening? The students are doing well. Let me ask the parents and grandparents, how's everybody doing this evening? We'll get them there. We'll get them there. All right, well, welcome to Arlington Baptist School Spring Concert. As you know, each year we do two concerts, our Christmas concert and our spring concert. And one of the things we like to do is use our students, whether in music or drama, and create music and drama ourselves. Not drama that, you know. Right, so you got it. But our students in the drama group, they have put together a play called Come to the Altar, and they wrote that themselves. So we want to enjoy that tonight. But when you think about coming to the altar, thank you. When you think about coming to the altar, coming to that place where you can get it right, coming to that place where the Lord resides, tonight, take advantage of that. Take advantage of the things that you hear tonight and ask yourself, am I there? Lord, show me. Show me how to get to the altar, Lord. Amen? Amen. A couple of quick announcements that I want to make before we pray. Enrollment. By the grace of God, our enrollment is well over 50% higher than it was last year. Some of you in here tonight may not have registered for next year, but I will tell you some of our classes are already closed. So please pay attention to that. Make sure your class is still open, all right? But it's still open. You know, go online, do what you got to do, and make sure it's there. We'll let you know. Next thing is, as far as computers, we raised close to $40,000 earlier this school year. Those computers will be on our campus this Wednesday, HP computers. So we thank God for that. All right, I'm not going to go any longer. We'll get the show started. Let's bow our heads and pray. Thank you, Lord. Great and mighty God, we do come before you tonight to thank you once again for the opportunity to come and share, Lord God, in song and in drama, Lord God, and praying that it all glorifies you. I do thank you for our parents and grandparents and friends and family who are here tonight, Lord God, and I pray that you will bless them tremendously. I also pray for our students that they will come up and do a wonderful job, Lord God. We do thank you so much for how you've blessed us. We ask tonight, oh God, that if there's that one person in here that does not know you as Savior, that one person will be drawn out, Lord God. Lord, we thank you because tonight, Lord God, let us all come to the altar. Let us all come to get it right. We thank you for the blood that was shed on Calvary so that we might be set free from the bondage of sin. For it is in Jesus' name that we do pray and ask these things tonight. Amen and amen.
No, I don't need help. I just want to die. Leave me alone.
I won't let you die. Lord, please help us. My name is Nova Jenkins. I'm at South Pembroke Park. When will the medics be here?
That's great, ma'am. Just try to keep him awake. Can you check if his pulse is there?
I mean, it is, but it's very, very weak. Please hurry.
The medics are on their way. They're almost there.
Miss, what happened?
This man, he fell and he's been coughing. I don't know if he needs help.
Do you know this man?
No, all I know is that he fell. I saw him on the side of the street. I don't know.
All right, miss, calm down. Please step aside. We'll take it from here.
Sir, what is your name?
My name is Charles Felix, for whatever that's worth.
Hey, I know this man. He's the one that runs that really famous.
What are you guys doing? Running your mouths without helping me? You're supposed to be helping me.
God can save this man.
I can't find his pulse. He's crashing. We need to take him to the hospital.
All right, we gotta get him to the hospital now. You take his arms. I got his legs.
Get the bag.
Come on, come on. Stay with us. Stay with us, man. Come on.
You got this. Just keep trying.
Mr. Felix, I'm Mr. Felix. bless you, sir.
Thank you. You have a good afternoon.
You too. Thanks.
Stephanie? Over here. Hey, it's me, Andrew. From the orphanage?
Andrew.
Yeah.
From the orphanage?
Yeah.
Wow, it's been so long. How have you been?
You know, I've been doing good. How have you been?
I'm doing well. What have you been up to?
Well, I've been, you know, out in the country, you know, helping everywhere. You know, I've been to Europe, I've been to Africa, I've been everywhere, to be honest.
Praise the Lord. I've been doing something similar, you know, doing some ministry with my church.
That's great.
Wow. Seeing you has brought back so many memories. And I wonder what the rest of our old friends are doing.
I wonder the same.
You know, ever since I left, I've been thinking, we should plan a reunion.
You know, that's a great idea, but I don't have any of their, like, you know, contacts. Do you?
No, but we could find them on social media.
That is a great idea. Hey, can I give you a number so we can plan it? Okay, thank you. Okay, I'll see you.
Bye.
Goodbye.
Later, they have the reunion.
Hey, can you help me?
This is the last one. Right. This is gonna be so fun. I can't wait for them to get here.
Let's hope they don't act the same like they were last time.
Been up to lately? We didn't really get to talk about it.
Well, yeah, I mean, other than, you know, going out and helping people across the world, I did get married for almost 10 years now.
That's great. Congratulations.
Yeah.
This is great. I can't believe we were able to get it all together so quickly.
Yeah. It only seems like it was like, what, a few hours?
Before they get here, I think we should pray. Why don't you pray?
Me? No, I think you should.
Come on, you got this.
Okay, but no judgment. Dear Lord, I want to bless this reunion, and I hope this reunion goes as planned, and hope that they do not act like they were at the orphanage. In Jesus' name,
amen.
I see you're still calling on Jesus. Did he answer yet?
Some people never change.
Welcome, everyone. Help yourselves. We have the space for 2 hours.
2 hours? Man, this place is beautiful. I might just get married here.
You get married? Oh, gosh, I feel bad for that one.
Man, cut it out. Andrew, you look good. How have you been?
Oh, well, thank you, Oliver. I mean, you haven't said this to me in, like, forever.
Man, some people change.
Oliver, you change? That's funny. Let God change you, Oliver.
Oh my goodness, we're about to have church.
I wouldn't joke about that. I'm thinking about becoming Christian myself.
Yeah, and Angel, I can gladly see you have a change.
I know I didn't ask for your opinion.
Hello? Yes, I know him. What's wrong? Okay, I'll be there right away. Guys. Remember Mr. Felix? He's in the hospital.
Wait, why is he in the hospital? And why is he calling you?
Yeah, why is he calling you?
I'm sure it's some God thing.
You know, you're really getting on my nerves.
I try my best.
Pull yourselves together, guys. I've been in touch with Mr. Felix ever since he, you know, fell off the edge. I'm like the closest thing to family he has.
Thanks, Stephanie. You're starting to make me feel bad about myself.
Family? You mean your family is one of the meanest men we've ever known. Why would you forgive him and want to help him?
Because I had to give him grace, just like God gives us grace.
Okay. Are we going to the hospital or what?
Come on.
Yeah, come on, guys.
Thank you.
Our Father, what my eyes will see when your face is before me. I can only imagine.
Talkative as ever, I see. Oh, all right.
still hear me, right? Four fingers, right? All right, good. So here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna go get your medicine, and hopefully you'll survive this, okay?
See you later.
All right.
Rest up.
Hold on. I want to pray for you.
Okay.
Dear God, I'm begging you. This man is in critical condition, and we don't know if he's gonna make it. I want you to put his hand on it. Your hand on his shoulder, and please, please stay with him, God. I beg you, because the devil is a liar, and we all know we can't let him go down with him. So if he leaves this world tonight, please, God, let him be a permanent resident in your home, oh Lord. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen.
You'll be all right, Mr. Felix.
We'll be right back, okay?
Hi, we're here to visit Mr. Felix.
You're talking about Mr. Felix, 14B, right?
Yes.
Can you sign in, please, ma'am?
They're all with me.
They are? And can I get your name?
Stephanie Davis.
What's your name? Andrew.
Wait, you're here to see me? After all I've done to you guys, you never gave up on me.
I mean, why would we give up on you? Even though you were harsh, you were annoying, and you always used to do shenanigans, you didn't give up on us.
Yeah, you took us in when no one else did.
Mr. Felix, I guess I could be nice, like, for 1 minute. We don't want you to go.
You know, just by hearing you guys' kind words and seeing you today, I know there is a true God, and I want to change. Lord, I'm a sinner, and I want to give my life to you because I've been a mean person. So I give my life to you for that change.
Mr. Felix, you're a Christian.
Even the thief on the cross was convinced that Jesus is the Christ, the Messiah. Today, we watch the sinner give his life to Christ in his very last moments. You heard the story. Now it's your turn to make a choice where you all will spend your eternity. God bless you. Thank you.
heart hurting and broken within, overwhelmed by the weight of the sin. Jesus is calling. Have you come to the end of yourself? Do you thirst for a drink from the well? Jesus is calling.
Oh, come to the altar. The Father's arms are open wide. Forgiveness was bought with the precious blood of Jesus Christ.
one more song in a moment. And we sure appreciate you being here. Students, quiet for just a minute, all right? Just for a minute. This is called "O Come to the Altar." Do you know one of the last things the Word of God has to say is this? Hey, students, be quiet for just a minute. One of the last things the Word of God says is this. Jesus, right at the end of Revelation, says, "Surely I come quickly." Come. Come always involves movement. Always involves it. Victor, come here. Good to see you tonight. Now go. Now watch. It's movement. I asked Victor to come, and I knew he would do it. He came, but it always means movement. So tonight it's called "O Come to the Altar," and Jesus says, "I come quickly." There is movement. So the last thing, one of the last things the Word of God gives, there's an invitation. Revelation chapter 22, I think it's around the 17th verse. And the Spirit and the bride say, "Come." And let him that is athirst come. So when you come to the altar, when you come to Christ, it always demands movement. Just like Victor moved from that spot and came right here, there was movement. Now you say, well, what if I don't move? What if I just stay where I'm at when it means coming to Christ? Then you have to follow whatever the consequences are. Tonight, you saw that in a drama. You heard it in the song. So the last invitation Jesus gives in his word is, come. Come. And whosoever will, Revelation 22, 17, let him take of the water of life freely. But you've got to come. And it always demands movement. Many of us here tonight may have had a time in our lives where we had a mental knowledge of who Christ is, what he did. But when there's movement, it moves from the head to the heart. I need a Savior. So I come to the Savior because I know this, he's coming very soon. Let me tell you what I love about our students is that every day when they're in the schoolhouse, they get to hear about Jesus, that he came, and then when they trust Christ, he's in their heart, and that he's coming again. And that movement makes a difference. So come. Come to the altar and watch what Jesus can do. If you never trusted him, I hope you'll trust him tonight. I can't think of a better thing to happen in your life than for you to have movement. Come to Christ. Would you bow your heads and close your eyes with me? We're going to have a word of prayer in a moment. But perhaps with our heads bowed and eyes closed, perhaps you're here tonight and I ask you this question. If you've ever trusted Christ as your personal Savior, do you know for sure that if you die, you'd go to heaven? If not, it's time to come to Christ. Come. Move to him out of your heart. And so right there where you're at, would you trust Christ? You say, well, how would I do that? Well, just talk to him. What do I say? Say this. In your heart, dear Lord, I know that I am a sinner, but I know Jesus died for me. I am coming to Christ. Forgive me of my sins. Be my Lord. Be my Savior. Help me to live for you. Thank you, Jesus, for dying for me. And thank you for coming into my life. With our heads bowed and eyes closed, not to embarrass you, would never do that. Perhaps you're here tonight and say, Pastor Campbell, I just want you to know that I asked Christ to do that tonight. Maybe you just slip your hand up where you're at, with heads bowed and eyes closed, say, just want you to know, Pastor Campbell, I did that tonight. I've trusted Christ. Thank you. Anyone else tonight? Yes, I did that. Thank you. God bless you. Thank you very much. Makes all the difference in the world when you come to Christ. Father, thank you for what we've experienced tonight. You've been so good to us. Thank you for your kindness and grace and mercy. And I'm thankful for all the good things you do in our lives every night, every day, every moment. Thankful for these students. What a blessing they are. Thank you for each family represented. And may we always point everyone we know to the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. For we ask in his name, amen. Don't turn me off yet. All right, good. I want my ushers to come. All right, where's my guys that are helping my ushers tonight? They're coming. Let me tell you just a couple things of why we do this. In 2 weeks, we have a big program here called the Acts Week. All right? The Acts Week is a big program. At that time, we reach out, really, into our community, but also we have a big project. That week, our students and a lot of from our church also are putting together 30,000 John and Romans in Portuguese that will all be shipped to Brazil and given to missionaries. So ushers, if you go ahead and start that, they're going to pass the plates. Everything you give goes toward our students putting those together. And we ship those then over to Brazil, and all these missionaries have 30,000 John Romans plan of salvations to give out all over that country. And so our students are going to help put those together and do that during our Acts Week. So everything you give tonight, every penny goes strictly to that. Doesn't go into the church, doesn't go into the school. It goes to help us cover that, to print those, and to ship those. Costs us about $7,000 to do it. But what a blessing. And our students, they get to put their hands on those and put them together and then help us as we ship them out. So everything you give on that tonight, every penny of it goes toward that project. All right? While they're doing that, a couple of announcements we need to do. Do we have some presentations that need to be made? Do we have some students giving something? All right, come on over. Y'all come on over here. Josiah, you going first? Oh, you're the only one going. All right.
We all trying to go home, so I'm going to make this quick, all right? For doing an amazing job on this amazing performance, the students, staff, and drama and choir classes would like to award Miss Joe, and Miss Murray these flowers as a thanks for your amazing jobs. Miss Murray not here, so I'm gonna go give them to her. So.
All right, Miss Murray's around here somewhere. All right, let me take a moment and let's also thank these two ladies for all the hard work they did. Miss Murray did the drama, Miss Joe the music. Let's thank them if you would. And then, if I might, I want all of our faculty and staff to stand. All of our faculty and staff, would you stand? All right. Some of them are already up here standing. But I want to thank them for all the work they did. Great job. Amen. We have an incredible group, incredible staff. They do a great job. And I want to thank them so much for all they're doing. And we're getting near the end of the year. You know what that means? Man, the end is in sight. So we want our students to stay faithful at it. And parents, thank you for having your students in our school. It has been a blessing. We've had a great year and look forward to even a better year next year and see all the good things God's going to do. All right? But we have one more song. Is everybody ready? I'll take that as a yes. After that, Mr. Whitehead will come and give us some final instructions. Thank you.
All right. Another big hand for our students. Good job, guys. Good job. So how we want to release the students tonight, I want to make sure they get back to their seats first. You're going to come down the aisle, come down the back aisle, and then come back, come down the middle, and then go out. And make sure you check with the teacher and let the teacher know you're taking the child, all right? But we're going to give them a chance to get back to their seats first. Did you guys enjoy yourselves? Amen. As you can see, they're very excited.